Test drivers who don't take breaks, like working overtime, never get tired and still drive just as well at the end of their shift as they did at the start. They don't exist, do they? Yes, they do. Here at the Continental Test site in Uvalde, Texas, the world's first prototype of an automated tire test vehicle is already in use. But at present, there is still a person behind the wheel for almost every tire test. The tests include seeing how newly developed tire models cope under real conditions, such as on off-road stretches. The extreme climate and the dusty gravel roads provide the ideal conditions. The tests are strenuous. Each driver carries out 1 8-hour test per day, taking a break just once every 2 hours.
We're driving very slow speeds on a very short circuit, and this leads our drivers to start not paying attention to the road and lacking the concentration needed, and this affects ultimately the consistency of driving.
So even the smallest driving error can have a big impact on the quality of the test results. And this is where Tomas Zusch and his team of engineers and students come in. For 2 years now, they have been working on the tire test of tomorrow. And it doesn't need a driver.
The idea is to automate tire tests and, above all, to standardize them to such an extent that we can identify even the smallest differences in the tires.
From the initial idea to the present prototype, it has at times been a rather rocky road. To get the vehicle to drive automatically on the test track, Zusch and his team combine numerous components that are already used on highways by Continental's automated cruising chauffeur. Although the technical specifications are similar to those for automated driving, they have to meet other requirements. With the off-road test tracks, for example, there are no road markings that can be detected by cameras. So, the vehicle relies instead on satellite navigation to determine its position.
We work with a GPS system that achieves 2 centimeter accuracy, and we are also able to reproduce that level of accuracy. That, of course, is phenomenal. We are always able to send the vehicle on exactly the same route, so that each tire experiences the same as its predecessor. This way, we are 100% certain that the differences we see are real differences, and not the result of variations in the test procedure.
The automated test vehicle offers even more advantages. For example, the vehicle can be sent on a route that is shifted by only a few centimeters, which helps protect the track so it requires considerably less maintenance. A human driver couldn't steer a vehicle that precisely.
I have massively reduced the maintenance needed for the gravel tracks, thus cutting costs substantially, and the reproducibility has become even better.
As innovative as the approach may be, the idea of a driverless test vehicle is not entirely new. Continental engineers developed an electronically controlled car to automate tire tests 50 years ago. At that time, the vehicle followed a wire, which was glued to the test track, and generated an electromagnetic field. Remotely controlled actuators in the car handled the steering, throttle, and brakes, without any need for a driver. In 1968, that was quite a sensation. Today's prototype is considerably more advanced than its predecessor.
At that time, they couldn't glue the wire to just any track they wanted. What we are doing here, on our off-road routes, for example, wouldn't have been possible at all back then.
In the meantime, the prototype is now so advanced that it is already being used in real testing. A driver still has to be present to intervene in the event of an emergency, but that's about to change.
The big challenge we are facing at the moment is to make the car really safe. We need to use our camera and radar systems for this special off-road application so that we can react to objects such as people, animals, or even vehicles that suddenly appear on the track.
The automated test vehicle does not only improve tire testing, it also relieves drivers of monotonous and strenuous tasks. In addition, the data collected during the test drives could be very helpful in developing the cruising chauffeur into an entirely autonomous vehicle.
The exciting thing about this project is that we have brought together a wide variety of specialist fields at Continental. And overcoming all these challenges along the way, as funny as it may sound, has been a lot of fun.
Das ist halt auch das, was einfach sehr, sehr viel Spaß macht.